In the past couple of videos, I neglected to talk about xdebug too much. But since in PHP Storm, I'm going to be debugging my scripts using the editor, the PHP Storm editor works in coordination with xdebug. During the previous video where I went through the process of configuring this stuff, at that time, I had upgraded to Ubuntu 16, both on the production server and in development. And after I did that, I ended up having to install the xdebug package. This is all covered in the September 2016 playlist, and you can actually see the video that's highlighted here. That's the one that covers it. I'm going to play a little part of that video just to show some of the things that were edited in order to make xdebug work. xdebug.ini. This first line was already there. And then I added these four lines. Okay. The next thing I had to do was go into PHP Storm's properties. So that's command comma. And then under the PHP node, that's what they call this thing, I went to debug. And then I configured these settings here and these ones here. And I clicked OK. I'm trying to remember how I used to debug. So bear with me. Okay. Let's say I want to debug this script. So I open it and I believe I would select one of these, run join, run test hyperlink, run join. Okay, so I would probably have to create a new configuration just for this file here. So to debug register.php, assuming I want to debug it as a web script rather than a command line script, I would click this and then hit edit configuration. And then I would click here to add a new configuration. Okay, and then I would say that the configuration I want to add is a PHP web application. Okay, I would have to give it a name. Let's say register web script. And I see the server has already been configured. So, and it's given the name debug sandbox. For start URL, okay, this would be the correct path because the web root of the Apache server on my virtual machine is actually pretty higher up in the directory chain. So that's what I would need over here. I guess I would hit just apply or okay. All right. And now if I try to debug it, I guess I would hit this. Okay, so it ran it and it stopped right here. And to step through it, I guess there's, what's this called? Show execution point, step over, step into. Okay, let's hit step over. Step over, step over, step over, step over. I didn't set any breakpoints, so it's just stepping over each line. Okay, you should see something happen on the web browser screen, but apparently there's a lot of lines that really don't do anything. I would really like to run the whole thing. Oops, okay, I hit step out and it just ran the rest of the script. Okay, so that's how I run the debugger. All right, I learned a little bit more about how the debugger works. Let's see, here's my script. And a good place to stop the script from running would be like right here. So I'll click right there. So there's a breakpoint. So now I hit, okay, this says run. Okay, I want to debug. And notice that register web script is selected. So I hit debug. Actually, what I could do is open this and What does this do? Rerun register web script. Okay, I could do that. All right, so it's running it. Okay, now if I press this, it runs it all the way to the breakpoint. Before, the mistake I was doing was I kept hitting step over. So I was actually executing the script line by line. But to run it to the next breakpoint, you hit this one. Okay, so it ran it all the way here. Let me show the... Okay. So now I hit... Okay, if I press this again, it'll run it all the way to the end. Okay, as you can see, it ran it all the way to the end and it displayed the page. And then, I guess this is for stopping the debugging. Okay, and then I hide the debug window with this. Okay, so that's how debugging works.